happened while Israel was still in Gaza. A little boy was supposedly shot dead, and France 2, France 2 television, which is a state-owned French television channel, got hold of some film, and they not only broadcast it, they made copies and actually handed video cassettes to all their main rivals like CNN and BBC. And France 2 correspondent Charles Andelin said that, first of all, the boy had died, and secondly, that Israel had killed this boy. In fact, it later transpired that Charles Andelin had not been in Gaza that day. He was in Ramallah, and a freelance Palestinian cameraman had given Charles Andelin the film. It absolutely inflamed the population, which is what the Palestinian authorities presumably wanted to do at the time by repeatedly showing the film on TV. First of all, there were doubts expressed because the angle that the boy appeared to be shot at did not come from the direction of where Israeli soldiers were stationed. So the serious questions asked of how could Israel be responsible, or Israeli soldiers be responsible for shooting this boy, when in fact Israeli soldiers weren't positioned in the line of fire. The questions were asked whether the boy had actually been shot, because the film is not clear in this matter. It transpired over time that the Palestinians on that day had deliberately play-acted scenes for the cameras. We know that that's the case for other scenes, for other incidents and injuries, because we got film provided by Reuters of Palestinians being carried into ambulances looking like they were seriously injured, and then a couple of minutes later they got out of the ambulance again and started laughing and so on. Charles Andelin and his crew only produced 18 minutes, i.e. only two-thirds of the film, and the judge was really quite surprised because she'd ordered them to produce all the film, and Charles Andelin mumbled some excuse about not having all the film and losing it and so on, but it certainly raised great suspicions as to what exactly is going on here. In the film that they did play, the boy that supposedly been shot dead, Mohammed Al-Dura, appears to move his arm after he's been shot dead and then open his eyes again. You have freelance photographers who are often freelance photographers and cameramen who are often partisan doing filming in a local conflict, and then editing the film, sending it to an international station like France 2, and then because of the pressure of 24/7 TV, international stations like France 2 will immediately broadcast it before anyone has had time to examine the film and its authenticity, and the genie's out of the bottle.